Hey everybody, and welcome to Save Point, a show on YouTube where we talk about video games and topics that you send to us on YouTube, Tumblr, Twitter, and Facebook using hashtag Save Point. I'm Michael Anthony.
I'm Nick Rubio.
And I'm Ryan Shepherd.
And we have a great show for you, and hopefully Ryan doesn't have a hysterical coughing fit and
die.
Yeah,
why would you say that? Because I can feel it in my throat. Oh god.
I can't do this. I can't do this level.
Okay. I'm going in.
I'm not on that level anymore.
Alright, I'm going in. Here it is. Alright, first topic is from Kid Icarus. At Peace Phil Peyote, I see you, homie. Who do you think is under the mask in the new Batman game, and thoughts on the forest? The guy under the mask in the Batman game, I don't think it's anybody we've ever seen before. I'm pretty sure Rocksteady has said that.
It's an original character?
That Geoff Johns created the character for this game, specifically. And the forest, I'm just too afraid. I can't do that. I can't.
It looks good.
I read about it quite a bit. Yeah.
I think it's a good take on things. I like how it's not multiplayer. It's a single player game. So it's not like Rust where you have to go in and you have to fucking compete with every other human on the planet. Yeah. And they're naked caveman rocks coming after you.
It's interesting because it's kind of like a non-linear progression game. Or rather, in a different sense where it's not like levels and stuff. It's like, how long can you survive? Mm-hmm. This time you lived 3 days. Well, maybe next time you'll make it to 4 or 5 days. I thought it was an interesting way to do that.
Hardcore Minecraft.
I mean, I know about it, and I know, like, it looks cool, but the fact that it's even slightly scary, like, I just can't. Like, the only type of horror games I can do are mainstream horror, like Dead Space and Resident Evil, because they're actually not scary. They're, like, moody.
You're telling me you didn't jump a little at a Dead Space 1?
The first Dead Space, yeah. But, like, I can't do Amnesia. I can't handle it. Like, I played some of that, and I was just like, well, I don't want to have a heart attack, so that's it for me.
I think I'd have a lot of trouble with that, too. I'm okay with horror games like Dead Space or Doom, where you can fight back. And that's kind of like with horror movies, too. I like it when it's, like, at least there's a struggle.
Mm-hmm.
But something like Amnesia, where it's pretty much like you run away, that freaks me out.
I loved Amnesia.
That freaks me out.
Yeah. I thought Amnesia was a great game. Outlast was another good game. That was a game where, like, you tried to, the game, it would make you think you could fight back, but you didn't. It was like you thought you could do things, and you thought what you were doing was having an effect. Oh, I'm not gonna die. No, you struggled, and then the chainsaw hit your face.
I don't know. I think it looks really cool. I honestly did. I remember a few months ago when it showed up on Greenlight or on Kickstarter, and I saw it. And I was like, that's cool. That's something I can't get into. Because I know I can't do it.
They take your child away, like, all of a sudden they're just gone.
Like, I saw the trailer that was, like, Alpha, that was, like, it was, like, oh, look, it's, you know, it was, like, the guy walking around, he's cutting down a tree, and he makes a little hut, and then he makes a little thing, and then, like, it got really dark, and he went into a cave, and then, like, that end of that trailer, like, switches to horror mode, and, like, you start to hear things skitter. I was like, this game is taking a turn. I can't do this.
So we're gonna get an Oculus Rift and put Michael on the specific.
Oh, I would do that. If
surround sound headphones.
I would do that.
And then he's gonna be on the treadmill thing where he has to run and he's just gonna stumble.
Can you cry in an Oculus Rift? Is that okay or is that damaging? This is like a legitimate concern. I would love to go to a conference and ask them about, like, hey, like,
can I cry in this?
Can I cry in this?
I'm a big crier.
I just imagine putting you in the treadmill thing and you running and you're in such a frightful panic that you tip the whole thing over.
Yeah.
It'd be
very top heavy. I don't know. I mean, I hope that helps, and I wish we could talk more about that Batman thing, but there's really not a whole lot to say on it.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it is an original character, so there's no way to really know who it is.
I mean,
I think it's interesting that Professor the Xavier suit I felt was very similar to Batman's suit.
I think the only thing I could tell you is that maybe Geoff Johns and the people at Rocksteady are trying to go, oh, the idea of Arkham Knight is an original character, but maybe Jason Todd's underneath it. But I doubt that. I highly doubt that. I think this guy's all new.
Who's richer than Batman? Who has more money than Batman? Who has comparable money to Batman?
Lex Luthor.
It would never be him, though.
No.
That's two hands on the, two boots on the ground for Lex Luthor.
Exactly. I don't know. I hope that answered your question.
Yeah, we'll find out.
We're having a lot of topics.
It's the lead singer from Rush. It is Geddy Lee.
It's not the Neil Peart?
Neil Peart. YYZ?
I don't know why that's who it is, but it is.
GamerX at GamerX at UnderInspired.
It's like a Scooby-Doo-esque villain. The old caretaker!
And I would have gotten away with it too if it wasn't for, I don't know what he would.
Your meddling gadgets.
Your incredible amounts of
do
money.
Do you
want
to hear about what the
skill.
Naked Batman man wants to say?
I'm sorry.
I do, actually.
Senor GamerX, the ever faithful and loving.
At UnderInspired, excited for E3 2014. Who's not? What are your thoughts? I don't know
what they're going to do because, like, there's so much news coming out right now.
It's the week before, so that some companies are trying to get it out. So they're like, hey, we're going to be there and we don't want to be drowning. Mm-hmm. They want Mortal Kombat just was, you know, announced. And what they want to do is they don't want Mortal Kombat to be drowning in the sea of news. They want you to know that it exists. Mm-hmm. So when the news happens, you can search it out.
I feel like E3 this year is going to be a lot of what happened last year, mainly because there was an article recently on Kotaku where they said they basically presented all the things that did Xbox promise all the things.
Mm-hmm.
Did they come
live
through?
Up to all of them, yeah.
And a lot of the things on there were not yet because there were games like Sunset Overdrive,
yeah,
like D4, games like Project Spark, games like Quantum Break, where like we haven't seen them a lot, and I feel like this is where we're going to see
a lot of the stuff yeah,
that was built up for E3 last year, where now there's product to show.
Like, if there isn't gameplay for Halo 5, I'll be very disappointed.
There won't be.
I don't think so. I honestly think you don't think so. Only Halo stuff that will be shown is Halo Compendium.
Exactly that the rumored compendium. So. One thing we know is not going to be there for, like, a Microsoft side is Quantum Break. They already said they're going to show it at Gamescom as the mm-hmm. first gameplay.
Okay.
But Microsoft has a track record of they announce a Halo, and the year before the Halo comes out, you see a trailer of, you know, of some story stuff, maybe some tease. So we might see a Halo 5 trailer.
Okay.
But the precedent has set for, like, almost all the Halos that it's the year before it comes out is just a trailer. The year it comes out, because they always come out in November.
Mm-hmm.
So the E3 directly before it comes out in June, that's the gameplay. So we won't see the gameplay until next year.
So, but we'll probably see gameplay for the compendium, I think. That's probably going to come out this year.
I want to know if they're going to create some sort of new multiplayer experience.
That, like, spans?
Yeah. I want to know if, like...
Just Halo 2 multiplayer.
Yeah. Like, or...
Done.
All the graphics are revamped. And it's every map from the first one to fucking now.
What I think would be really interesting is if they introduce, like, a forge system where you could spawn different generations of things. Like, can you imagine, like, having a Halo Combat Evolved Generation Ghost, or be able to have, like,
Halo 1 pistol, which is just OP, just boom, done.
Because they're quite a bit different.
Over time, they
change quite a bit. Like, the, what's the Hunter gun?
Plasma Fuel Rod?
The Fuel Rod Cannon. Fuel Rod Cannon.
Even though it never did what it's supposed to.
I think it was significantly more powerful in the first two games than in the later ones.
And now it, like, it bounces off of everything, and now you have to, like, hit an elite, like, a million times.
The Fuel Rod in the first two games was the nuke of the Unreal Tournament. It was comparable to the nuke. Like, you had to find it. It was, like, very hard to find. You couldn't find it.
Mm. Yeah.
It was difficult to discover.
Man, I miss Halo multiplayer, so I'm excited for that. I really do miss it.
I want it back to its raw things. As much as I like the whole, you know, trying to change it up with the perks and the jetpacks and the running things, I like just the shoot 'em ups with shield, and everybody's on the same playing field, and you don't have to fucking think about who's invisible and shit.
All right, so on his topic, though, what are the three things you guys are most pumped for? Me? Mortal Kombat. I'm not gonna lie to you. I love Mortal Kombat.
Mm-hmm.
If you guys listen to our podcast, you know I love Mortal Kombat. I want to hear some new Mortal Kombat stuff. I want to see some new Metal Gear Solid stuff. I'm a huge
fan. That'd
be
great, yeah.
We have some videos up, and we're gonna be bringing you some more of those. I love Metal Gear Solid, like, to death, even though it's super confusing. And then as much as I am a more Microsoft centric guy, I honestly want to see what Sony's up to, because if Sony, like, I owned a PS3, I didn't really play it, I only use it for Metal Gear Solid 4. But if they have a good game that's interesting, then I'm going to buy a PS4.
Yeah.
Like, I already know I'm going to buy an Xbox One. There's some games on there, and there's games coming out that I know I want. But if they show me something that I really want to play, then I'm going to go buy that PS4, you know?
Right,
so, I just want to see, like, the main things, I just want to see the two big people's press conferences, and then some Metal Gear Solid and some Mortal Kombat.
Okay. You have a three?
Yes, I have three. Doom 4.
No,
they're definitely gonna show Doom stuff, because the beta, you know, if you pre-order Wolfenstein or bought it.
Even
copy,
a trailer, there's gonna be some Doom.
Yeah.
Do you think it's going to be Doom 4, or do you think it's gonna be like a restart?
Just Doom.
Because I feel like Wolfenstein was kind of like a restart.
They said Doom 4.
Well, they said 4?
Doom,
didn't
they? Doom,
everything I've seen just said Doom.
Well, Doom didn't have the issues that Wolfenstein did.
Yeah.
They tried to bring Wolfenstein
back.
It's a
very strange story.
Exactly.
Yeah, Doom at least had a very streamlined story. Mars, demons, you know, stuff like that. So,
but not even that. Like,
the
when
staples.
You, when you look at sales, Doom has never had a problem.
Yeah, Doom
but
always
if you look at the Wolfenstein before this, I forget what it's called, but the
it
Wolfenstein
was
before
just Wolfenstein.
It just 3D.
Wolfenstein. It was Wolfenstein 3D, and then there was Wolfenstein.
Exactly. Those two games didn't actually do that well. Yeah. The most recent Wolfenstein that's not the New Order did not do well, which is why there's another new Wolfenstein.
I didn't even know there was a Wolfenstein before the New Order. Mm-hmm.
Doom, and then what else?
Doom, I'm looking forward to. I want to see more for Sunset Overdrive.
Yeah.
There's going to be, hopefully, stuff shown up like that. And Witcher 3.
Oh, yeah. That's a good one. I didn't
Witcher
think
3.
About that.
Now that he actually brings it up, I'd love another trailer,
for
something.
Cyberpunk 2077.
CD Projekt Red to be like, okay, it's active. No, we're not done. Just for them to confirm that they haven't canceled it. That's all I want.
That little tiny bit they showed for Cyberpunk 2077 was amazing.
There's too much money. There's no way.
I guess for me, it's hard. Has Valve ever had any big announcements at an E3?
I don't think they run that. I think the only thing
we
ever
really
saw.
Do that.
The only thing we ever saw was Gabe Newell say
maybe,
that's games on the PS3.
You know what? Maybe they're going to show that new want to. Or no, that was Bethesda. Never mind. Bethesda showing that game to try to compete with Team Fortress.
Which
that
one?
Like hack and slash.
Oh,
four.
The
yeah.
one that looks almost like a Dishonored
Steampunk.
Game, but it's not.
Yeah.
Oh, it's not.
I know what you're talking about.
Yeah. But that's Bethesda. That's not Valve.
I guess for me, I'd actually really like to see if Bungie comes forward with some stuff for Destiny.
Mm-hmm.
Something big for that.
I'm sure they will. I'm sure Activision's going to be like, hey, look at us. Hey. Please,
we spent $50 million
please
on this.
Please buy this.
$500 million. All right. So, Destiny would be one. I think I honestly want to agree with Sunset Overdrive just because it looks like such a fun game. And, man, I honestly, on the whole, would just like to see Microsoft have a better conference this year. Because
exactly.
They did so bad last year.
I don't think they did bad. I think they were just... They set themselves up to be picked on.
I think, yeah. But that's what I'm saying. That's they did a bad job because the reception is everything.
Mm-hmm.
I want to see them actually knock people off their feet somehow.
They stuck with all their promises though. That was a good thing about the Kotaku art. Everything they said happened.
And I don't know.
Except for all the stuff that hasn't come out yet, which isn't on Microsoft's part.
But except for the things when they're like, yeah, you're never going to be able to buy a Kinect without... I mean, you're never going to be able to buy an Xbox One without a Kinect. They said that. They're like, look, it's not going to happen.
Well, that's a Mark Whitten thing. Mark Whitten was the former head of Microsoft Studios, and it's now headed by Phil Spencer.
Yeah.
And Phil Spencer has righted the ship. And, like, even though, like, Nick has an Xbox One, and I have, you know, and I'm more of a Microsoft-leaning guy,
mm-hmm.
We try our best to be objective and not be fanboy-y,
mm-hmm.
because ultimately at the end of the day, if Microsoft rights the ship and they do a killer E3,
yeah.
then that means Sony's gonna be like, okay, we need to step it up. And that means Sony's gonna bring the heat. You want the competition. As much as there are people who be like, oh, Microsoft's always gonna suck, Sony's always going to suck. You want them both to do good because when they both do good, it creates competition.
Mm-hmm. Competition gives you
the good games.
I want Sony to have a really good conference without being so combative about it.
Mm-hmm.
Like that's one thing that bothered me about E3 is at times it almost felt petty because
they really promote petty fanboyism.
It was an attack. They were like, oh, here's how you trade games on a PlayStation 4.
Mm-hmm.
Like, no, don't do that. Like
they keep flame wars going.
Let your product speak for itself. Don't do direct attacks. Show us what cool, awesome things are coming out. And just lean on that. That's what I think.
Does that cover that?
Yeah.
I'm excited. Actually, now I'm thinking about it. I'm excited for like the Ubisoft press conference.
Unity.
Yeah.
No. Honestly.
Arno. I know you want to see Arno.
I do. I do want to see some Arno. Honestly, just I want like some Splinter Cell, and I think Ubisoft is a great staple. We're gonna see. Actually, now that I'm thinking about it, we're gonna see Far Cry 4. At the Ubisoft press conference.
The best thing they could do is that whoever the representative for Ubisoft is walks out, grabs the microphone, and goes, "No more Uplay." Mic drop.
It's Aisha Taylor every year.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
God, Uplay is so terrible. God, Uplay is terrible.
It really is.
All right. Well, let's move on, guys. This is from Jason O'Malley. Joe O'Malley, 4,000 million numbers. Do you consider mobile gaming to be the same as core gaming, or are they completely different gaming sectors? I think we've talked about this before.
I think we have.
Where, like, I think, you know, mobile gaming is its own thing in its own right. But I think it's still mostly a distraction market.
It is mostly, but that's not to say that there aren't like hardcore like no one's going to go like what's the Unreal game, the fighting game, you know, where you swipe the screen.
Infinity Blade.
No one's going to look. Oh yeah, Infinity Blade. That game is nothing. You know what I mean? Like there's some power.
Republic
behind it, you know
was
what I mean?
A good
Republic.
You know what's going to bring?
Even
a heavy
Telltale.
Hitter?
Telltale brings all of their. they brought The Walking Dead and they brought The Wolf Among Us. Those are all you can play on your on
Hearthstone
your iPad.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's
Hearthstone.
They are going to bring those to phones at some point, and I feel like that's going to bring because I'm sorry,
man. That sounds like it'd be real hard on your eyes.
If I could play Hearthstone on my phone, I would. Well, my phone screen's pretty big, so
yeah. I mean,
I play Worms 2 Armageddon on my phone.
Maybe a few years ago you could say they were different, but now, like, the way the market is, the fact that you can make a free game or a dollar download on an app store and be financially viable, like, you're starting to see a lot of growth in phones. Like, you've seen it for a few years with games like Infinity Blade and stuff like that, but now more than ever, like, with Republic and with Hearthstone coming to it, like, It's a wonder that Nintendo's 3DS somehow survives among the fact that you can get some serious games on your
phone. Speaking
of
which, Underinspired is making a game. We're looking for Apple developers with 3 years of Swift experience.
Oh yeah, their new language they just came out with.
Is it?
Yeah, they because that was always a big joke that, you know, if you try to go for like an Apple development job, they would always ask for like 3 to 5 years of like Objective-C experience. Yeah. So now everyone was joking like, oh, now you need the Swift experience, even though it's only been out for a day.
But
I'm not learning that.
I had to make my over-the-top joke. I'm sorry.
I totally
there's,
forgot what
there's
I
was one tech guy in Seattle. Ha! That was it. That was for you.
But what was the question again?
You think there's one tech guy in Seattle?
No, I mean, but it's the only tech guy left. All the other ones are just like. Mm,
what I want to see with mobile gaming is I think that like stuff like Candy Crush or any of the games where like it relies very heavily on microtransactions, I think it's kind of bad for mobile gaming. Some of them because like they're really, I feel like they're kind of toxic.
Well, you know what happened with Peggle, right?
No.
Okay, so if you guys have played Peggle, it's made by PopCap. You guys know PopCap makes great games. They make fun games. And Peggle's the one where you shoot the ball and you have to hit all okay.
It's like Kalinko?
Yes, kind of.
Isn't it Pachinko?
Pachinko, yes.
Pachinko.
I don't know.
But, so, they have a version of Peggle that you can download in the United States. You pay for up front, it's like $4, $5, and you get the whole game. They took that version of the game off the market in Australia and released it, again, for free, with a free-to-play version, where it's like, oh, you ran out of balls, would you like to pay $1 for another pack of balls to shoot down the thing?
I don't like that.
Like, and people, like, it's horrible. It's ridiculous.
Because people will dump thousands of dollars into these games.
And that's the thing. And it's like, you get that number skewed where you see, oh, overall growth, overall, maybe it's financially more viable. But that's because this is just one guy who has no life and decides he's going to spend
He's
going to spend his entire Christmas bonus on gems and Candy Crush.
But the
and
thing
stuff
is,
like
though,
that, you know? Like,
it might not just be that guy. It might be that person who has like an addictive personality.
Yeah.
And I think that, you know, that's part of the reason why gambling is illegal in so many places, because it attracts people who have a compulsive need to do it. Mm-hmm. So you get these people who are like, oh, it's just $2. It's just $2. It's just $2. And they just.
I dated a girl who was like that. I always thought that was the funniest thing, where she like spent. You know what I mean? Like, there's one thing when you're supporting developers and games that are larger scale where you're actually getting some value back for it. Like, games in Dota and say, even World of Warcraft, you're getting things for it, and you're not just, like, you get extra time to play this game.
Exactly.
Paying $5 so my house builds now instead of in 10 hours.
Exactly.
All you're saving yourself time that you literally just have to wait. You know?
Exactly. And you could argue, like, I don't have the time for that. But you do have the time for that because you can do, like, if you say, oh, I have a busy schedule. That's just another reason why you shouldn't spend the money.
Yeah.
Because you can set it to do its own thing and wait 10 hours and do those things that you claim you have to do in that 10 hours.
And they know people are impatient. They play on it.
Exactly.
I don't know. That's my thoughts on it. I don't know if you guys know. Do you have a question for them?
What are you guys excited for at E3?
Yeah. How are you feeling about E3? What games are you looking for? Technologies? Are you looking for the next Nintendo installment? Because we all know we are looking for that.
I'm a little worried that we know everything that they're going to talk about. I don't think they're going to knock us
out. You hear that they stopped production of the premium Wii U model, the 32 gigabyte version?
Did they really?
They just because they can't survive. It's they're
well. I heard their sales spiked because of Mario Kart 8.
Yeah, 1.8.
Yeah. Yeah,
but that's still.
But
like,
that's a topic for another time. Yeah. We're done. We're not gonna get into this. We're not getting into this.
Anyway, let us know what game. What are you excited for, Eddie?
Yeah. Goodbye.